In this learning module, we will examine the different filter types which are available for limiting data and visualizations. After completing this module, you should understand how to use each filter type and know how to change filter types as required. In the Filters panel, you will see non-numeric data columns represented as checkbox filters, radio button filters, and list box filters. While these are the most common filter types for non-numeric data, columns may also be represented as item filters or text filters. Numeric data columns are most often represented as range filters, and if the data column is a date or date time, calendar icons will appear at each end of the range filter. With that common understanding of vocabulary relative to Spotfire filters, let's work through a follow-along demonstration together. Use Open File and navigate to the example with filter types in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. By default, an in-memory data table will produce a filter for each column of data. However, if you are connected to an in-database data source, you will have to create filters for the desired columns using either this icon or a drag-and-drop approach in order to populate the filters panel. We will, instead, work within this in-memory data table example, where values have been collected from sales at an office supplies company. On the next page, we will use filters to limit data in visualizations. Many of these filter types are intuitive to use. For example, we can uncheck the order priority values, which are low or very low, and rows containing those values are removed from the visualizations. And the calendar icon on this range filter can be used to change the minimum order date to July 1st, 2011. However, there are other interactions with filter types which may not be quite as intuitive. For example, if you wanted to set the minimum sale price value at 5,000, the minimum value displayed can be double-clicked upon in order to present a field which allows you to enter that threshold minimum value. Once you hit the Enter key, all rows with sale price amounts below 5,000 are filtered out. Let's take a moment to consider the impact of these filter adjustments. Only rows with order dates on or after July 1st, 2011, with urgent, high, or medium order priority values, and sale price amounts at or above 5,000 meet our established filtering criteria and contribute to the 371 rows of data which we have filtered to. The scatter plot on this page has been configured to display only the data available in those 371 rows. The bar chart has been configured to display orange bars based upon the data which has been filtered to. However, a shadow which reflects the bar height for unfiltered data is also displayed. Other visualization types may also be configured to display different subsets defined by filtering. For example, the subsets variable has been applied to the columns dimension of our trellis matrix. Now, one column of pies reflects the 371 rows of data which meet our filtering criteria, while another column of pie charts represents the 6,719 rows of data which do not meet our current filtering criteria. Let's reset all filters and return our focus to the different filter types which are available. While unchecking values on a checkbox filter is intuitive, there may be occasions where a different filter type is more efficient. For example, if we wanted to isolate only high priority orders, we would have to uncheck, 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 and uncheck. Then, if we wanted to examine other order priorities individually, we would have to check, uncheck, and check, uncheck, each time we change the view to a different order priority value. A more efficient filter type for this data limiting goal would be a radio button filter. After right-clicking on the filter and changing the filter type to a radio button filter, isolation of any one value requires only a single click. We can also return to viewing all values with a single click. However, note that unlike a checkbox filter, it is not possible to filter to two values at the same time, like urgent and high, with a radio button filter. You can consider the radio button to be an all or one filter type. If we change the order priority filter type to an item filter, you will discover that it has the same functionality as a radio button filter, only it has a different orientation. With an item filter, you can move this box to the right in order to view one value at a time. After you've activated this filter, you may find it easier to step through values by using the left and right arrow buttons on your keyboard. And you may return all values by sliding the box all the way to the left in the item slider. Why would you want to have a column represented as an item slider? Well, you might consider an item slider rather than a radio button when you have longer lists of values which take up too much vertical space when presented in the form of a radio button. But you still wish to step through views of individual values as the result of your filtering actions. Another option would be to change the order priority filter to a list box filter. The list box filter has the distinct advantage of allowing you to select a single value or multiple values in an efficient manner by dragging your mouse through adjacent values. In addition, multiple selection of non-adjacent values within the list can be performed by holding the Control key. And again, all values can be returned by clicking the All item on the list. List box filters are quite useful in the case of longer lists of values, like we see here in the Sales Associate filter, because this filter type includes a search field, which may be used to limit values displayed in the list. For example, if we type the letters MA, only those associates whose first or last names begin with MA remain in the list. Typing additional letters will further restrict the values displayed in the list. Note, though, that no filtering was performed. This search field serves only to limit the list of values displayed. Filtering is not performed until you select a value or values in the list. You may clear the contents of the search field in order to view the complete list of available values, but note that the data is still filtered. Select All to return the filtered out data. If your ultimate goal is to filter using these text search capabilities, there may be a more efficient approach. You can change the Sales Associate filter type to a text filter, and when you type the letters MA, all customers whose first or last names begin with MA are immediately isolated. If you continue to type, the data is immediately limited to values which match your updated search criteria. Using this filter type requires a certain structured quality to the data in the column and some knowledge on the part of the user regarding what to type in the text search field. Clearing the contents of the text filter field will return values which have been filtered out. While checkbox, radio button, item slider, list box, and text filter types are generally suitable for categorical data types, continuous measures like days to deliver or delivery date are generally represented as range filters. There are two ways to interact with range filters. You can use them to dynamically adjust the range of values displayed. Notice that adjusting the minimum value to 27 in this data range has already filtered out the majority of rows from visualizations. Consequently, this approach to filter adjustment may be useful as a way to add a dynamic dimension to your visual analysis and assist you in the exploration of data density. Note that once a range filter is activated, you may use the left and right arrow keys in order to adjust the minimum limit incrementally. You may also use the up and down arrow keys in order to adjust the maximum limit incrementally. If we return those sliders to display the full range of data, you may recall that the alternative approach to working with range filters is to double-click on a minimum or maximum value in order to set a specific range limit. For example, we could double-click on the minimum delivery date and type October 12, 2013. Hit enter, then double-click on the maximum delivery date, type October 12, 2014, and hit enter. Now that we have defined a specific range on this filter, we could grab the dark gray filter 2 range in the middle and reposition it along the full range of values in order to view different slices of the data. Notice that the width of the window defined by that range remains constant. Let's right-click and select Reset Filter in order to return the filtered out data. Now it's time for an on-your-own activity. Use the indicated filter criteria to isolate the data of interest in these visualizations. Click the play button when you are ready to continue. In your efforts to complete this activity, you may have used the calendar icon to adjust the maximum delivery date, clicking the title region to step back to the year 2013, then selecting the indicated month, January, and day, the 1st. When it came time to adjust the ship container filter, you may have unchecked multiple times. However, I hope instead that you chose to change the filter type to either a list box filter or a radio button filter type, either of which would have made it easy to filter to the desired value, jumbo drum, with a single click. We could scroll up to find the next filter of interest, and uncheck to filter away the unwanted out-of-stock values. However, there is another way to locate filters of interest. Typing in the search field here will limit the filters displayed in order to help us quickly locate the profit filter. If you attempted to set the maximum value on this range filter by sliding the upper limit triangle, you may have become frustrated with your inability to set it exactly at 1500. Hopefully, you remembered that double-clicking on the maximum value displayed above the slider presents a field which will allow you to enter a specific threshold value, then submit by pressing the Enter key. If we wanted to return all filters to the Filters panel, we could simply clear this search field. Another handy search term which you may find useful is status:mod. Typing this search term into the field will limit the filters displayed to only those filters which have been modified or adjusted to limit data. You may wish to make a mental note of the status:mod search string for future use. Anytime you ask yourself what filters have been adjusted, entering status:mod will immediately limit the filters displayed to only those filters which are currently set to limit data, thereby providing a quick answer to your question. Again, if we clear the search field, all filters are returned to the Filters panel. There is one more way to limit the filters displayed. If we right-click anywhere in the Filters panel, we can launch the Organize Filters dialog and slide it aside so we can watch as filters are either hidden or reordered as a result of our interactions within this dialog.